Hello, everybody. Welcome back to another episode of Kavanaugh's Corner. I'm Andrew Kavanaugh. As always, thank you for coming back to our channel. Today, I got my all-black outfit going on here because I'm here to talk to you about a new movie, an original movie that is exclusive to Amazon Prime Instant Video right now, and that movie is called Elvis and Nixon. And Elvis and Nixon is actually a pretty funny. I can't call it a docudrama, but it's more like a based on real event comedy, I guess. It entails the adventure of Elvis Presley visiting President Nixon, and I think it was 1970. I think it was 1970, 71 or something like that. And it is a really, really, really funny movie that has a lot of really funny moments. Also, some moments that are actually kind of telling about the time that the movie takes place in, the whole air of that time period when Nixon was in office and the kind of revolutionary tone that a lot of people were taking during that time period. Kind of an interesting film in that aspect. First and foremost, I got to talk about the two main leads in the film. I got to talk about Michael Shannon as Elvis and Kevin Spacey as President Nixon. I have to say, these guys are unbelievable. They are so fantastic. Shannon and Spacey really don't feel like they're doing caricatures. They feel like they're doing more of, like, I want to say not an imitation of the real people, but they're doing more of a psychological reenactment, which kind of is hard to explain. Michael Shannon looks a lot like Elvis did in that time period. There's only one thing that he didn't get right that I'm going to talk about later. But Kevin Spacey as Nixon doesn't do an outright like Nixon impression, but he gets the mannerisms and the look of Nixon, especially the voice. He gets that down really well. Not as good as Frank Langella did in Frost Nixon, but definitely does a really good job of portraying the president's attitude and how he was during that time period. I think it's very interesting. Now, I never met the man, obviously, but from books that I've read in the past and things, interviews from people that actually worked with him and knew him, he got it pretty well. He got a pretty good depiction of him in this film. I think the nice thing is about this film and how Michael Shannon portrays Elvis in this is that I think Michael Shannon really got the whole mindset that Elvis had during that time period. It's pretty easy to say that Elvis was pretty friggin' nuts during this time period. Elvis was known, and actually Steve Martin told a story about this a while back. Elvis was known to carry like multiple loaded weapons on him during this time period. And I'm talking about like he had a 45, like a Colt, 45, 1911, like in a shoulder holster under a jacket. He had like another one in his back, like in the small of his back. He had like two full-size 45 automatics on him. He had a gun in his boot. He had like a 25 caliber like pistol in his boot. Like this guy was nuts. Like this guy was completely nuts. But he felt like he had this patriotic duty for whatever reason during this time period to serve as an undercover agent. It's just a federal agent at large is what he refers it to in the movie, but he felt like he wanted to serve the country in some way, shape, or form. He felt that the country was falling apart during this time period, and his whole goal of the movie is he wants to get to the White House to meet with President Nixon and have him swear him in as a federal agent at large. And this actually happened. Like, this is a real thing that happened. And he was actually sworn in, but supposedly never did anything. And it kind of makes me wonder, did he do anything? Which is kind of a funny question they pose at the end of the movie. But, again, without spoiling anything for the film, the movie really does go through the zaniness of him trying to get into the White House. It's so crazy that this actually happened. But a lot of the things they show in this movie did actually happen. Some of it, I guarantee, is dramatized, you know, to the nth degree because it's a movie. But there are some really funny moments, and I know for a fact there are a few things in this movie that really did happen, and some really funny situations Elvis found himself in that are absolutely real things. Going back to Kevin Spacey, Kevin Spacey's part as Nixon in this movie is a very small part. He is not a major role, and you really don't see him for an elongated period of time until very near the end of the movie. But his air, like his kind of like being, is felt throughout the whole film in a weird way. He's very funny. One thing I do have to say about this movie, it's a very funny movie. He really does capture Nixon's spirit. Spacey does. He really gets his whole attitude, which I think is great. And like I said, there are some very genuinely funny moments. There's a moment in the film where Elvis calls up, I think it's the ATF, I think it is, the Alcohol, Tobacco, and Firearms. I think it's, he actually calls them up. And the reaction that the receptionist has when she answers the phone is absolutely hilarious. And it's great because the very next scene when Elvis actually goes in there to meet with the head of the ATF, her hair is completely different. All the girls in the room are all changed their makeup and stuff because, of course, they knew Elvis Presley was coming. And I think that's great. I think it's so great because I think that's how women would have reacted during this time period. It's so funny. It's so great. And I just think like Shannon captures that kind of like nutty 70s Elvis, where he was doing a lot of the kung fu karate stuff. It's really, really funny stuff he does in this movie. Elvis was gaining a little bit of weight during this time period, and Michael Shannon is a pretty thin dude in this movie. He's a pretty thin guy. He always is normally very thin. He's a very thin actor. I've never seen him weigh a lot. But they really didn't do anything in terms of makeup to make him look anything other than the way Michael Shannon looks. And I guess that was, again, out of respect to Elvis, that they didn't want to make a caricature of him, which I think is good. I think it works good the way they have him in this film, because you get the psychological aspect of how he's kind of going bonkers, but you also feel for him because he does have a few really touching moments in this film as well. And it really does add to the whole psyche of Elvis during that time period. And you really do feel bad for him, because he was really not allowed to do anything on his own. And when he does try to do something on his own in this movie, he makes a terrible mistake, which I'm not going to give away. But it's a real thing that actually happened. So it's, again, really funny scenes. Colin Hanks is also in this movie as one of President Nixon's, I think his, I don't know if he's his chief of staff or something. I can't remember the exact character that he plays, but he plays one of Nixon's staff members, White House staff members during this time period. And he's very funny. He does a really good job. And I'm not the biggest Colin Hanks fan, but he does a really good job in this movie, and he does provide a lot of laughs, as well as some really interesting moments historically wise. I think he does a pretty good job in this. Everybody does a really good job in this. The only thing I can say about this movie that I could nitpick about is that the direction of the film is pretty bland. There's no really kind of like moments I can speak of that really stand out in the film. The movie is shot pretty normally, and it's shot kind of like a TV movie, which is really too bad because they got the atmosphere, they got the cars, they got the clothing right of the time period. They did a really good job with establishing that this movie took place in the 70s. Even the interiors of an American Airlines flight during this time period is pretty much dead on. I mean, they did a really good job with that. The music is also is all of that time period, which I think is pretty good. But there's one thing that is a major flaw for this movie, and it's a big thing, and I have to talk about it, is this is an Elvis movie where there's absolutely zero Elvis music, which I think is the biggest load of bullshit that I've ever heard in anything. Like, I've never seen anything that's that much bullshit. They went out of their way to capture Elvis of this time period, the 70s as a whole, even Nixon's kind of like presidential, his whole term, I guess, is really well depicted in this movie, even though it takes place in a very short period of time. They went out of their way, you know, to make a movie about Elvis and Nixon, and there's no Elvis music. And I can't understand how they couldn't get the rights to at least one Elvis song in this movie. There is not one Elvis song. It's not a big deal. It's really not. I'm making it kind of more of a big deal because I'm a big Elvis fan and I really like his music and I got a kick out of seeing this kind of time, this portrayal of him during this time period. But no Elvis music? It's like, are you kidding me? Anyway, whatever. I mean, that's a small nitpick. Like I said, besides that and the direction being bland, the movie is very enjoyable, it's very funny, and it's also kind of educational, because this actually did happen. So if I had to give this movie a rating, I'd give it like a 3.5 out of 5. It was worth watching. Is it worth buying an Amazon Prime membership for to see? Hell no. No, definitely not. But It is a really funny movie. I got a lot of really good laughs out of it. And if you're an Elvis fan like I am, it's really interesting to see a movie finally made about Elvis during this time period. Anyway, I want to say, you know, thank you again for coming back to Kavanaugh's Corner. As always, I'm Andrew Kavanaugh. Until next time, we'll see you. Bye-bye.